Hello, everyone, and welcome to Computex Learning Beyond Borders podcast with me, Aishwarya Ravishankar. I work as a marketing lead for Computex College, and today I have with me a very special guest who has been doing a great job in terms of helping newcomers and immigrants succeed in tech industry and entrepreneurship. She is Nuhela, and she's the founder and CEO at Scale Without Borders. It's my great pleasure to welcome you here today, Nuhela. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great. How are you doing?
I'm doing good too. Thank you. Super excited to be chatting with you to learn a lot about, you know, newcomers, immigrants, you know, tips and strategies for them. I'm sure there's like a lot to cover.
Same here. Absolutely.
So first of all, congratulations on getting your Canadian citizenship. I recently learned from one of your LinkedIn posts and I feel happy.
Thank you. Yep. I'm super excited about that as well.
Yeah. So I also learned from your LinkedIn post that you mentioned that you moved to Canada at the age of 17. You left Morocco as an immigrant. So at that point of time, Nuhela, did you have any aspiration that you will become a business owner someday?
Absolutely not. When I moved to Canada, I was just focused on what major am I going to pick for my university and how can I survive being an international student in a new country? Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, cool. But what led to the, you know, creation of Scale Without Borders? What do you think?
Sure. So it was organic, really. I found myself in the tech industry, which is absolutely not what I studied. I studied politics at U of T. And I was very excited and grateful to be in tech because I was working on projects that I was really passionate about, including a project for refugees, and then later on helping women tech founders succeed and grow their businesses. And when I was working at the incubator for helping women founders, that's when I was inspired to also start my own business. And I saw that there was an opportunity, a gap for immigrants specifically in tech at that time. And I just launched my first event and it was like one small initiative after the other that kind of like snowballed into what is now Scale Without Borders.
That's awesome. That's interesting to know. So my next question would be, you know, related to the challenges, because, you know, we talk a lot about newcomers and immigrants at Computex College. You know, we have been functioning for the past three decades, helping newcomers and immigrants succeed by giving them, you know, a lot of interesting programs in business, healthcare, and technology. So what do you think are some of the biggest challenges, Nuhela, that newcomers and immigrants face when they are, you know, trying to break into tech in entrepreneurship industries? And how does your team address these challenges?
Sure. So there are a few challenges as a newcomer. So first of all, the tech industry, especially if you're talking about, you know, I would say like the scale up, the venture capital industry, then, you know, joining like a venture backed tech startup, for instance, it's very tight knit. So it's unfortunately, but also fortunately in some ways, all about relationships, who knows who. So that's obviously one big challenge that newcomers face. And that's one big thing that we are solving, which is bringing the tech industry to newcomers and having, you know, doing events where you wouldn't never meet or you wouldn't meet these people right now as a newcomer. So having events for free to have newcomers join us and kind of connect with these people and build authentic relationships. So that's in the network side of things. The other thing is like understanding a lot of our community, at least, are very skilled in tech. And for those who are looking to brush up their skills, we do have programs for that as well. But it's really the navigating the Canadian tech ecosystem as newcomers that becomes difficult. So how do you understand the work culture in Canada? How do you understand how to sell your skills as a newcomer in Canada? How do you speak to employers in a way that is convincing and in a way that they understand in Canada? So that's another thing that we change with our programs and we educate our newcomers about. And then I would say the third thing is really not in the hands of newcomers, which is bias from employers and sometimes straight up discrimination. But we are seeing a change in that in that area. And lots of employers are now advocating for You don't need any Canadian experience. We actually love your international experience. And those are the kind of employers we want to work with and that we promote. And those are the employers that newcomers should look for. So any employers who don't want you because you don't have Canadian experience, I would say just let them go.
Absolutely. So as an immigrant entrepreneur yourself, do you think there are commonly held misconceptions about immigrants and their abilities to thrive in this field?
Are there misconceptions about immigrants?
Mm-hmm.
Well, there's as I mentioned, there's bias, right? The misconception is that, you know, if you don't have Canadian experience, then you're not going to be useful to me. And again, lots of employers are don't think this way. So I want to make it clear that there are many employers out there who would love to have you. But for those who you need Canadian experience, the misconception is that you can't transfer your skills here. So mm-hmm. that's a big misconception. Or that I think a lot of people are also starting to understand that diversity is a big thing. And it is as much also a business move as much as it is other kind of, it has other benefits as well. Mm-hmm. So I think a lot of employers are starting to realize that, but I would say that is the biggest misconception from other people towards immigrants.
Yes, yes, totally, totally, 100% agreed. And since you mentioned about diversity, I have to, tell something to you that we at Computech are always proud of. Computech is so diverse. Like me as a marketing lead, I get the opportunity to meet and work with colleagues who are from different parts of the world. And it's so interesting to, get to know about their culture, the way they, work and the way they talk. And it's very interesting. Here at Computech, and same with the student community that we have, it's very diverse.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you're targeting newcomers, which is an amazing thing, so you're going to get diversity.
Yes, absolutely. And this particular question is the question that I ask to most of my guests who are, industry experts. So what are some of the most important skills or qualities that immigrants need to succeed in the tech industry, and how can they develop them?
Well, let's start with tech skills. But I think a lot of newcomers and immigrants, at least from our community, they do bring a lot of experience and tech skills already. So, of course, you need to have the relevant technical skills for the relevant job you're looking to fill. Mm-hmm. But then also the leadership skills, right? Mm-hmm. So the non-technical skills, because at the end of the day, you are going to work in an environment with fellow humans, and you need to be able to communicate in a way that is effective and efficient. To land your job, you're going to need to understand how to navigate the tech ecosystem. As I mentioned, you're going to need to understand how to sell your skills. And then to retain your job and to grow within your job, you're going to also need those non-technical skills as well, particularly within the Canadian context. Mm-hmm. So those are things that I think a newcomer would, they're new, they don't know, so they would, it's a good idea to look into that and try to find ways to kind of gain those non-technical skills.
Definitely. So this is interesting that you mentioned about non-technical skills. What are some of the resources, do you think, or where can newcomers and immigrants go to learn these non-technical skills? Because we here at Computech, we offer, education, but mostly it's the subject knowledge or the theoretical knowledge, but the practical or the soft skills or the non-technical skills that you mentioned, where can students go or where can newcomers go to learn them?
Sure. Well, of course, I'm biased, and because we identify this issue, obviously we offer solutions to that. So we have all of our programs have non-technical skills as well. So we'll have the technical layer, but also the non-technical skills. We also do run a program that is specifically just for selling your skills, understanding the Canadian tech ecosystem, and it's free. So you can definitely join our network just by going to our website at scalewithoutborders.com. The other thing I would say is also, there are also settlement agencies out there that do great work. You can look into that. But also, it's just practice, right? Like going to events, especially in tech, interacting with people, understanding. When I first came to Canada, or the second time, because I came twice, I went to a lot of events, and that's where I learned, what is this industry about? What's happening? What do they want? How do people interact? Mm-hmm. So I'd say practice is really important, and I really believe in learning through practice. And then the training is sort of like also complementary.
Yes, sure. So when you say events, I totally agree that events are important, like networking events or events that we can, you know, participate to understand things. But what are some of the roles or that students or newcomers can take in terms of, should they just go and attend an event or should they participate in any kind of, you know, activity there, or what kind of things that students or immigrants can do from your perspective?
Like in the event?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. To actively engage and to expand their connection.
Yeah. So first of all, listen to, like, as a newcomer, it's really, a lot of people are like, oh, events, they say the same thing. And you know what? To some extent, I agree there are some, it can be exhausting, it can be redundant. But if you're a newcomer, I would highly recommend you sit on the front row. Or if you're very shy, you can sit at the back row. And you can listen, first of all, to what's happening. What is happening in the Canadian tech ecosystem? Things that are happening in other countries are not happening in here. So what is happening, even if you are a tech professional, but also especially if you're not already in tech? Then I would also recommend, definitely the networking portion. So connect with people, make friends. Really, I made friends who are now some of my best friends, and they also happen to be colleagues, former colleagues, future colleagues. And, you know, just be yourself and build relationships. I wouldn't even consider it like networking or having any specific strategy, other than, of course, do follow up with people, have a way to collect information and follow up with people and kind of, you know, set up virtual or in-person coffees or lunches or whatever it is that you want.
Absolutely. Yes, totally. But, you know, sometimes it's not only about, you know, establishing a network. It's also about how do you prolong or how do you sustain the relationship and take it to the next level? Right. And as you rightly mentioned, it's following up. It's having, a little coffee chats and things like that here and there.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. So how does Scale Without Borders partner with other organizations or companies to provide resources and opportunities for newcomers and immigrants?
Sure. So we're big on partnerships. We have all sorts of partnerships. We can't do this alone. From like strategic partnerships to, well, all our partnerships are strategic. But let's, for example, say we have our programs are in partnership right now with a Ontario Tech Talent, which is a subsidiary of an Ontario Tech University. And that's how we provide a lot of our technical programming. Or we have partnerships with charities to do research on newcomers. We have about newcomers, so we can better understand like what are the challenges they have, what are the challenges employers have, how can we get more employers to hire. But then also the biggest partnerships we have are with our employers. That's what we do, is to get them to recruit newcomers, and we work with them. How can we build their pipeline, the diversity pipelines? How can we, or the pipelines in a way that is diverse? How can we help them recruit? So those are our biggest ones. We also do have community partnerships. As I mentioned, we're big on collaboration. So with settlement agencies, so we can kind of support and complement their work as well, and other nonprofits.
Mm-hmm. And that's interesting to know. At Computech, one thing that we realize is, like, as I said, Computech focuses on business, healthcare, and technology programs. And especially with the technology program that we offer, what we learned over the period is, like, most of the students that we have are new to tech. They do not know they do not have any idea about what computer network and cybersecurity is, but they are very interested. And once they, graduate, they get to learn like so many new skills. And once they graduate, they are getting, placed with good job offers. So what I'm trying to say is like people who are even new to tech have the opportunity or the chance to get good career in the technology industry. So what do you think for individuals who are new to tech or entrepreneurship industries? What suggestions would you offer and how can they utilize the resources provided by Scale Without Borders? Additionally, how could, you know, enrolling in Computer College's computer network and cybersecurity program would be beneficial for them?
Sure. So, sorry, there was a few questions in one. So, let's start with the first one. So, how can newcomers benefit from our resources in tech and entrepreneurship? Is that it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Sure. Well, you can sign up, as I mentioned, to our scalewithoutborders.com website. There's a join network prompt, and you can just sign up through that. It's free. By being part of our community, you will get kind of content to help you navigate your journey as a newcomer in tech. You will get private invites to events. Vast majority of our events are free, some in person, some online. So whether you're here already or you're coming or you're in a different province or in Ontario, that's okay as well. You will also hear about our programs that we built. They are very competitive, but you'll hear about them so you can apply. Our application process is very easy to do, so you can leverage that. Engage, come to the events, apply to the programs. When you're part of a program, engage in the program. Of course, that's the best way to leverage. And I always say, we can only do so much for you. At the end of the day, it's how engaged you are and how much you can leverage these opportunities.
Right.
So that's for that question.
Right. So the next, the follow-up would be, you know, how do you think, you know, students who are new to technology industry, how can they get benefit out of the program that we offer here at Computech? You know, be it Computech or any other organization, just basically, you know, enrolling themselves in a degree or diploma program to get sort of your, you know, what Canadian education is all about, right?
Sure. Definitely if you're new in tech, you're going to need technical skills. So there is no way around that. There are definitely people who self-teach, who are self-taught, and that's totally fine, but it's always nice to be part of a program to get guidance. So that's something you can get from Computech College, I understand. But I would also say, like, it goes beyond that, right? It's about what you do with it. Just like with us, it's all about what you do with your work. Getting a technical diploma is good because it gives you the skills and it also gives you the recognition. It can help you overcome that Canadian experience issue. But again, as I mentioned, there are many employers out there who will not look into that. So don't be discouraged. So that's one way you can take advantage, but always do your own work, do your own networking, look what's out there, connect with people, learn outside of the kind of classroom as well.
Absolutely. And are there any upcoming initiatives or projects that Scale Without Borders is working on to support newcomers and immigrants in tech and entrepreneurship? I know you mentioned a lot of events. So I'm just asking here because, you know, how can Computech students or maybe graduates benefits out of the upcoming initiatives or projects at Scale Without Borders?
Absolutely. Yes, we always have. But right now we're very excited about our upcoming summit happening in the fall. We're going to announce some exciting details over there, but it's going to be a 2-day party for immigrants in tech to help them, as I mentioned, understand the Canadian tech ecosystem, connect with Canada's most powerful tech leaders, people who are hiring, connect with peers, other newcomers, and just really have a great time. So stay tuned for those details. I'm very excited about that one.
I'm so excited. So I know we spoke about, you know, partnerships, collaborations, and, you know, upcoming initiatives, but I just wanted to specifically ask, you know, how can Computech students and staff get involved with Scale Without Borders, whether as volunteers or partners or any other, you know, collaborative opportunities coming up in the future?
Sure. The best way to get involved is to join us in our network and to come to our events. and come out, really show up and engage. I would say volunteering, we have very limited volunteering spots, and they're typically because we are a business and we hire for employees. For volunteer spots, sometimes we'll have folks at the summit who will help us with the event itself on the day of. So like, for example, check-in. So definitely, if you're looking for that, you can reach out to us. But they, again, very, very limited spots. The best way to get in involved is really to join us in our network.
Definitely. Yeah. This episode was really insightful. And thank you so much. And I really appreciate your time, Nuhaila, because, you know, I know you're a very busy person. You've been, you know, having a lot of events and then you're doing so many things. But thank you so much for your time and interest to participate in Computex podcast. Really appreciate your time.
Thank you. This was so much fun. I appreciate it.
Thank you so much. I think we should keep chatting and then maybe see you next time. Until then, ta-ta, bye-bye, and see you. And thank you, everyone, for patiently watching this podcast. I'm sure this podcast will be useful for many of you or at least some of you. So please make sure you show the support by like, share, and subscribing to this Computex podcast. See you some other time with some other interesting episodes. Until then, it's Aishwarya signing off with Nuhaila. Take care.